once, and she likes to be quite frank, Mrs. Clemens.
Bobby, I want you to fix these packages. They sound like sandpaper running together.
Want me to wet them down?
Okay.
You have enough water while you're here? I'll have a little drink while you're preparing for the burger.
Thank you.
What are you thinking about?
Are you home?
Am I home?
Oh, God.
What do you mean, am I home?
Soaking. It's raining out there. My feet are chunks of ice.
You know, funny thing, in Los Angeles, almost everybody has cold feet.
Oh, no jokes, please.
No jokes, really? How about a gentle humor? You like to hear an anecdote? How about an anecdote?
Did you see my kid? Isn't she beautiful?
Oh, that's nice, Marty.
Yeah, I'm giving up older people. Can't photograph them without their clothes on.
I love you.
Where were you?
Oh, I was out, I don't know, you know, shopping. And oh, then I stopped for a drink. Went into a bar. Shouldn't have done that.
A lot of people, men?
Yeah, but they were all talking about their children, so I figured it was okay.
I don't trust people that talk about their children.
Huh?
They're perverted. But I tell you, I do love older people. Look at this thing. You know why I love older people?
Why?
Because they know everything. But they don't show that they know everything. I can stand here, I can look at this woman, this old lady, and I can count every wrinkle on her face. And for every wrinkle, there's a pain, and for every pain, there's a year, and for every year, there's a person, there's a death, there's a history, and there's a kindness. Now, you look at this kid over here, she's not kind. See? What am I holding you up for? Go on, get upstairs, get warm.
I love you.
Virginia?
What?
Can you hear me?
What?
Thank you.
For what?
For coming home.
They want to be loved. They have to be loved. The whole world. Everybody wants to be loved. When I was 17, I could do anything. It was so easy. My emotions were so close to the surface. I'm finding it harder and harder to stay in touch.
Think about it, will you? I'm not mad at you. You could hit me. I'm not mad at you. Think about it.
Hit me. How you feel?
handout there tonight.
Yep. Here, give me your hat. Kelly, get me a bottle, will you? I need a drink.
A little one or a big one?
A big one.
It's nice to be loved.
I'm entitled.
You need a little bit more water on the hair?
You can do it on the way in. We've got plenty of time. Hurry up and wait.
Okay.
Is that everything?
Do it.
Seen every one of your plays here in New Haven. Would you please? I think they're wonderful.
Oh, interesting. You've seen every one of my plays in New Haven.
Well,
he's seen every one of my plays in New Haven.
Well, that's remarkable.
Oh, may I have your autograph?
Well, I'm just a producer.
Oh, please, please.
Sign it, Dave.
Yeah,
how are you? Please, please.
How old are you?
17.
Oh, my God.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Let's go. Let's go. Please, people. Let us real hard.
Stay back.
I love you. I love you.
Darling, let go. Please. All right.
Get the car. Get her. Get her. Get her.
All right?
Yeah, never mind, yeah. Hey, Manny, roll a window down, will you? There's something wrong with that kid.
Get out of the rain, will you? You're gonna get pneumonia. Come see me tomorrow, okay?
Handle, will you?
with you.
Listen, there's been an accident in front of the theater. I want you to call the police and be sure that they know it.
We've got to eat.
The Orpheum Theater.
Orpheum? We've got to eat.
What?
The last restaurant's going to close. You're going to be hungry later.
Oh. Maurice, will you come up with me, please? I feel a little shaky.
I'm not staying.
Have one drink. Come in. Don't be so distant, Maurice. Come on, have a drink.
Hungry. There are people waiting downstairs in the car.
What's the matter with us? When we lose sight of everything, it's a girl killed tonight. It's all we can think about is dinner.
I gotta go. Not a woman to me anymore. You're a professional. You don't care about anything, do you? You don't care about personal relationships, love, sex, affection.
Okay.
I have a small part. It's unsympathetic. The audience doesn't like me. I can't afford to be in love with you.
Good night.
She doesn't want to eat.
She'll beat herself into the ground.
Let's go. My wife is waiting at the restaurant. I don't want any more trouble. Let's go.
I need your help, Dorothy. I'm not talking to you as your husband. I don't count. But I'm going to go crazy if you don't tell me what it's like to be alone as a woman. Hey, what do you do? Okay, that's it. Please. I'm gonna get drunk. If you want to get hostile, you go ahead. My goddamn life depends on this play. And you should go to all the rehearsals. You should watch everything. You should sit with Myrtle, fill her in on yourself, and be part of it.
Do I get paid for this?
And if you understudy, I'll pay you. That's right. Because I tell you, my life is getting boring. I'm getting somber. My own tricks bore me.
Do you want ice?
Yeah. There's no humor anymore, and all the glamour's dead. You notice that?
Mm-mm.
I can't even stand how they come to rehearsal. Come to rehearsal dressed in terrible clothes.
Manny, I'm dying. I'm dying. I know I'm dying because I'm getting tired. It's always the same. You talk, I sleep. If I had known what a boring man you were when I married you, I wouldn't have gone through all those emotional crises.
No, sweetheart. I'm still up. Oh, I'm sorry, you're not feeling well. Do you have a fever? What? What girl? A young girl got killed in front of the theater tonight. Yeah, all right, sweetheart.
It's 4:30 in the morning.
Yes, I know it is lonely. Oh, I hate out of town, too. Of course I love you. Hold it, will you please? No, it's nothing, just my wife. Right. Of course I'll leave the phone up. Yeah. She doesn't mind at all.
Tell her you talk to her in the morning.
I don't sleep
see
anyway.
Her in the morning.
Right.
Right? Right.
There's no one I love more than you at this moment. You know I love you. What? Yes, we do. Okay. Well, what's wrong with being slapped? Cut it out. Cut it. Just a second, darling. Cut it out, will you please? There's nothing humiliating about it. Well, you're on the stage, for Christ's sake. I mean, he's not slapping you for real. Myrtle. Myrtle. Myrtle, it has nothing to do with being a woman. Now, you're not a woman anyway. No, you're a beautiful woman. You are. I was kidding. Now, you see, you have no sense of humor. I told you that. I don't want to argue with it, darling. We'll rehearse it. Well, how if we don't rehearse it, we won't get it. But it's not humiliating. There's nothing humiliating about it. It's a tradition. Actresses get slapped. It's a tradition. Now, do you want to be a star? Do you want to be unsympathetic? Now, it's mandatory. You get hit. That's it. Now, go to sleep. Right.
A young girl got killed by the theater tonight.
Let's forget it. Let's not phone it up anymore.
Myrtle, honest to God, he's not going to hurt you. Now, look. You do it to me. Come on. Do it to me. Here. Loosen the hand. Ready? Hear that? One more time. Okay. Now, hit Maurice. Good! Good. All right, we could do it, but, you could swing at you and and miss, but then we wouldn't hear the slap. So, try it one more time. Hit her in the face. With the fingers, not the palm. Right.
No!
Sorry.
Murder.
Take it easy, will you? What's the matter with you? Do I love you? Do I want you to be good?
Yes.
Would I hurt you?
No.
Well, then you're going to have to let me slap you.
Okay.
Huh? Yeah. It won't work if you don't. All right? Okay. Let's go. From where, Sarah?
Start with you don't get to me.
Okay. Places, please. You don't get to me. You want to get to me? You don't get to me. There's no way for you to get to me. You want to go out and get drunk? You want to take dope? You want to go out with some guy at 4 o'clock in the afternoon and be with him? Go ahead, that's your problem.
What a mess I am. I'm begging again. What are we fighting about?
You want to be young again, isn't it?
Oh, my. Ah!
Oh, that was... Wow. That was good. That was good. I didn't hit it.
Walk away.
Sorry. I didn't hit it, David. Really.
You all right, Martha?
We need a doctor.
No, right.
Yeah, you better get a doctor and get me a cold compress and maybe you'll have a little brandy back there.
David, would you please leave the stage so we can go on? Off the stage. There's nothing the matter with Myrtle. She's, tired, that's all. I've been tired a lot of times in my life. You stay up all night, you get tired.
All right, Myrtle. Time to get up. Have to rehearse now.
Let's take a look. You want me to try this again?
Yeah.
Start again?
Mm-hmm.
How can I start again when she's lying half dead on the floor?
Myrtle! Are we rehearsing here or not? You want to call it a day? Myrtle!
I was very much in love with you, Virginia. You don't get to me. You want to get to me? You don't get to me. There is no way for you to get to me. You want to go out and take dope? You want to get drunk? Go ahead. You want to...
expect to be funny in this scene? I'm sorry, I am. Perhaps I could write a funny line for you.
She's very alien to me. And I would pray that I could have something to say that would make sense, so that I could make sense. I seem to have lost the reality of the reality. I dream funny dreams too. I'm not myself.
This woman you're playing is as helpless as you are, as helpless as I am. She has no weapons. She wants to fall in love, but her time has passed. It's too late. It's as simple as that. You understand that part of it, don't you? How old are you, Myrtle? You see, it's too late. You understand that, don't you? Just please tell me what this play doesn't express.
Hope?
All right, we'll pick this up later. Let's start with Act One, Scene One.
All right, Jimmy.
What's up?
Be nice.
May I sit down? There's no sense in us being enemies.
But I can't be your friend if I have to contend with your retirement.
Oh, I don't think we'll ever be friends.
Well, we'll just have to live with that. You know, that was a very good point you made about hope. Made me realize that you're not completely stupid. People change physically. There's a hell of a lot of pressure one puts on oneself by demanding to stay competitive.
Beautiful day.
What do you want to do? You want to walk? You want to ride?
I don't care.
Oh, I hate actresses. She tried to talk to me about age. Now I ask you.
Yeah.
Really?
Come on, walk with us. We're going to walk.
I think that went very well. Thank you. So. Do you want to have a drink? You
yeah,
guys?
Good idea.
Huh? Hold on. Wait for me. Myrtle?
Come on, have a drink sometime.
Well, Manny, I just can't.
Are these all the local newspapers?
Yes, ma'am. Are you all right?
These are today's, aren't they?
Yes. These are the morning and those are the afternoon.
Okay. Would you put those on my bill, please? Oh,
certainly, Miss Gordon.
What's wrong?
Bye, please.
Do I have any mail?
One moment, please. Nothing. Would you like a key?
Repeat after me. Baruch.
Baruch.
Ator.
Ator.
Adonai.
Adonai.
Eloheinu.
Eloheinu.
Melech.
Melech.
Ho'olam.
Ho'olam.
Dayan.
Dayan.
Ho'emes.
Ho'emes.
Praise be thou, O God.
Praise be, O God.
Righteous judge.
Righteous judge.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm Myrtle Gordon.
Look, excuse me, but this happens to be a very, very bad time for us.
Please be quiet. Take it easy.
I lost my daughter today. You must forgive us. I know who you are. At another time, this house would have been bedlam had you paid a visit. Come in.
She was trying to see you. That's how it happened.
Yes, she was very beautiful. I did see her. She had extraordinary eyes.
You don't have children. If you had, you wouldn't have come here.
No, I don't. I don't have children.
Lion eyes don't smile at me. Kills romance too easily. For love is like coming home again.
Can I freshen you up a little bit, Miss Gordon?
Hold my breath and count.
Yeah, but just one more. I've got a show to do tonight.
Okay, listen, I don't want to impose upon you, but this joker down here has been begging me to get a couple autographs for his kids. Would you mind terribly?
No, it's fine.
Fantastic. There you are. You got him. I told you she was a fantastic broad.
Great. Thank you, Miss Carter.
Thanks.
How are you, Kelly?
Working. Hanging up clothes.
You're looking good.
Well, we all have to please. We have to please our audiences, isn't that right, Mr. Vickers?
That's right, that's right. Very intelligent. Hey. You're not funny anymore.
It's a serious play, man.
Look at that, isn't that wonderful? She knows it's a serious play. I mean it, you're not funny anymore. You used to break me up. That's right, I just have to look at you. I fall on the floor laughing. But you've changed. Your whole countenance has changed. You're like some proud queen. I think you're in line for a few bad habits. So, I'm gonna take you out after the show. Then I'm gonna take off all my clothes and show you this beautiful body. Hey. You're the most exciting woman that I've ever known. And the greatest actress. But you're no fun anymore.
It's a sad play. She didn't write.
Sit down, will you, please?
Look in the mirror. Am I beginning to look like Humphrey Bogart to you?
Oh, wait a minute. Let's discuss that.
No, answer the question. Am I or am I not Humphrey Bogart? You're upsetting her, Manny.
Shut
she
up,
doesn't
please,
sleep
Kelly.
At night.
Kelly.
There's no time. She has to go on.
I'm not funny because I can't take myself seriously anymore. I'm just so struck by the cruelty in this damn play.
Miss Gordon. You're on. Bus lights down. Places, please! Curtain!
Hey, there's a woman here. And she ain't bad looking either. Hey, she left.
Virginia!
Tony!
Hey.
Tony!
Look.
What are you doing?
I'm married. Give me a break.
Tony doesn't like me to interfere. Charlie, get away from the door.
Maybe she's a house detective from the noise.
I'm sorry. I'm going out there.
What happened?
They're at the staircase. They're talking.
Do you think he knows
them? Yes, the first wife.
Look, you've got to understand, it's a shock for me to see you. I'm not seeing you alone on a street corner somewhere. I didn't bump into you in a crowd.
Hello? The hell is going on here? Who is this dame?
This is Virginia. Wait a minute, Virginia.
Wait a minute.
I expect you to say hello to my family.
Hello.
Hello.
This is Mac's wife from 15 years ago. And this is my new wife.
Wait a minute, Virginia.
Listen, I'm really awfully sorry to
Carla,
just come in on you like this.
I want you to meet Charlie Spikes. This is Charlie Spikes.
I got a letter from home that said Tony.
My daughter, Leona.
Hi.
My wife, Lena. This is Virginia. Say hello to Virginia. Shake hands. Come on.
I feel I'm intruding.
My son, Vito. You have met my son, Vito? God damn it, no! You have met my son, Vito.
What's going on?
Get away from me!
He's alone. He's an ass.
And you shut up, too. This is my wife. She's a princess. See my kids? I got a lot of kids. I got three here, and I got two back home. My wife hates the population explosion too, but she don't mind having them because she has easy babies. That's right. Get away from me. That's right. She goes in and 15 minutes later, pop, they come out.
All right, Tony.
Is that right?
What are you doing, Tony?
Lena, listen. You don't understand what I'm saying. I'm saying it because Virginia doesn't like kids. And all my kids going
out of line, Tony. Now take it.
Hey, Tony, just leave him alone. Virginia. Just leave him alone, you bully son of a bitch. How dare you? Who do you think you are? You have no right.
All right, I'm sorry.
Carl, and I'm not afraid of you. I'll kick you right where it hurts.
All right, I'm sorry.
What do you want? What kind of woman are you?
Hey, come here. Come here.
Tony,
you son of a bitch!
Hey,
keep away from me!
Tony, you leave me alone! God damn it!
Tony,
stop it!
Get the hell away from me!
You can't!
Just keep him away from me!
Where are you?
Get away from me!
You can't just stop it! I mean, you're hurting your wife, you're hurting your kid! I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. See this? I wore this veil because he used to be so crazy about veils. I'm sorry, I'm a stupid woman, and this is very embarrassing, and I'm just sorry. It's just that there's such a difference between what you dream about and what's really there, isn't it? Oh.
What's the matter? Come on, now stop it. Stop being a pissant. Go out there and come on. Get the shit out of it. Come on now. You got it.
I'm sore at you. I don't know why.
What are you doing? Talking to your pictures?
Where were you? I've been home all afternoon. I've been home for a couple of hours. Hey.
Marty, I want to tell you something.
Is it the end of the world? You want a drink?
No, it's not the end of the world.
What is it?
I'm not good enough for you.
You're not good enough for me?
No.
Well, I don't want to hear that. I really don't want to hear that. You're my inspiration. Before I met you, I was a bum. I was a drunk. I was a drunk with a pad. I was W.C. Fields without a nose. I was Dean Martin without any charm. I was no good, really. I thought that small talk was too small. I thought big talk was too pretentious. I thought music was noise. And I thought art was bullshit. That's what I thought. I know you're no good, Virginia. You're just a girl, two legs. I know that. But I love you. You see, I'm not too secure. I'm step by step. But I know you, you see. I know you because I look at you while you sleep. Did you know that you sleep with half your eyes open? And did you know that?
I went to see my first husband today.
Oh. Well, really? How was he? Was he interesting? Was he good looking? Still? Was he disappointing? No, I guess not. Well, that's normal, you know.
Listen, I promised I'd never double cross you. I told you as long as I was here, I'd be straight with you.
I was very much in love with you, Virginia.
When was it? No, come on, really, I would like to know.
You don't get to me. You want to get to me, you don't get to me. There's no way for you to get to me. You want to take dope? Go ahead. You want to get drunk? Go ahead. You want to go out with some guy? 4 o'clock in the afternoon, be with some guy? Go ahead. That's your problem.
What a mess I am. I'm begging again.
You want to be young again, is that it?
Oh, Marty. Oh!
All right, get up. Sweetheart, get... Sweetheart, did I hurt you? Virginia, I didn't hit you that hard. Are you all right? I was going to call a doctor.
Don't be afraid. I love you. You're a wonderful actor, Maurice. We must never forget this is only a play.
I think it's wonderful how you told everyone that Maurice is an actor. I mean, no one would have known if you hadn't told them. And I think it's marvelous how accurately described to the audience what they were watching, a play. Bravo.
You're being sarcastic.
You understand something.
Now, Myrtle, do you like the part?
No.
You feel she's confused?
She's not confused,
Well, no. You feel she's happy? You feel she's sad? What is it you feel?
May excuse me a minute. Well, does she wreck you? Does she distress you so much you can't sleep at night?
David, I know you're trying to help, but... Well, how can you represent someone if you have no respect for her? I mean, we all know you changed all the lines tonight. Doesn't that tell you something? I mean, don't you say to yourself, Myrtle, maybe I'm not so smart. Maybe Sarah's play has something to say. Maybe I haven't loved anything in my life. Maybe I should have gotten married. Maybe I should have had children. That ever occurred to you?
Years ago.
I don't want any smart answers. I don't know what the hell this is. What is it? You want to be loved on the stage?
No.
You feel this woman is sick?
No.
You feel she's confused?
She's not confused.
Well, you feel she's happy? You feel she's sad? What is it you feel about her?
Nothing.
Listen, every word that Myrtle says is on paper. Here we're sitting around talking like she has to manufacture the words. You see, there's act one, act two, act three. All you have to do is say the lines clearly and with a degree of feeling. And then the Virginia will appear.
Oh. Now the goddamn tears. Keep me up all night. I could tell you I love you in front of my wife. Now we get your goddamn tears.
Oh, come on, Manny. That's too strong.
All right.
David, I want to talk to her. Wait outside, right?
Okay.
I'm not sorry, too. Come on in. I have a bar set up. How about a drink?
No, thanks.
Oh, come on. Loosen up a little. Have a drink.
No, thank you. I don't want one.
Sit down. Should we call room service? You're not hungry?
No.
How old are you, really? I'm trying to be patient. How old are you? I'm 65. How old are you? Well, if you can't say your age, then you can't accept my play.
I accept my age.
Why can't you read my lines?
Listen, Sarah. Every playwright writes a play about herself. You've written a play about aging. Well, I'm not your age.
What is your age?
I'm aware that playing an older woman is part of my problem. I have no illusions about being a teenager. You know, on stage, you have Virginia having hot flashes. So I don't have hot flashes. I'm not going through menopause. I'm not ready to play grandmothers yet. You know, you're very clever. If I'm good at this part, my career is severely limited.
Limited to what?
Once you're convincing in a part, the audience accepts you as that.
As what?
As old, that's what, old.
Are you gonna quit?
No. I'm looking for a way to play this part where age doesn't make any difference. Age isn't interesting. Age is depressing. Age is dull. Age doesn't have anything to do with anything. Listen, Sarah, I don't have a husband. I don't have a family. This is it for me. I mean, I get my kicks out of acting. If I can reach a woman sitting in the audience who thinks that nobody understands anything and my character goes through everything that she's going through, well, I feel like I've done a good job.
You think that anyone who's old can't be vulnerable?
That's not what I'm saying.
What are you saying?
When I was 18, I could do anything. My emotions were so close to the surface, I could feel everything easily. But now, this is years later. Plays later. Years later.
So, what's the answer?
I have this dead girl. You know, you remember that kid that was in the accident?
so open. She's really... She's really just on top of everything emotionally. She reminds me of...
You said you have this dead girl. What does have mean? Is she here now? In this room?
Good night, Sarah. Sarah.
Well, I thought I'd buy you a drink.
I'm so tired, David. No, I can't see you now. I don't want to see you. No, I'm with someone.
I'm very concerned. As long as somebody's going to be with you, I'll say goodnight. Good night.
Good night, Dave.
For Christ's sake.
What the hell are you trying to prove?
Give me.
Huh? What are you trying to prove? You're acting like some grade school theatrical kid, for Christ's sake. Everybody loves you. You're a super high-priced profession.
I'm what?
Now, calm down. I'm what? Calm down.
I'm what?
Calm down,
what?
Will you?
I
don't know what the hell it is. What is she? A political fantasy? Frustrated vision of Sarah's own inability? I don't know anything about this play. I don't know anything about this woman. I told my wife tonight. I said, Dorothy, I don't know what this play is about. I don't know what this woman is about.
Manny, she's not even like some bum, you know? She's not even a bum. She's a bitch. She's nothing. I mean, if I play her the way everybody wants me to play her, like some little over-the-hill matron, my career is a... I'm sick to death of hearing how old this woman is. Who gives a damn how old this woman is? Does she win or does she lose? That's what I want to know.
I know.
Is that such a lousy question?
I know.
I'm beginning to feel guilty for asking, for God's sake.
I like the music.
soothing sound. I used to play it on my stereo. I was always alone, waiting for time to pass, waiting for night to come. The movies don't start till 6. I dream with the music till dinner. Go to a movie or a concert. Boys. And men. Older men. And boys. Always pick me up.
I don't want to hear about your sex life.
What the hell are you doing?
If I could rid myself of you.
Are you going over your lines?
Only I didn't have to think about what's going to happen to you. If I could rid myself of the thought of being your wife.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I know you're frightened that I'm going to go too far in the wrong direction. You're afraid I'm going to make a fool of myself, aren't you?
No.
You're afraid that somehow my behavior is going to undermine you.
Don't meddle. Here we go. Come on,
Gordon, please, for an autograph.
All right, people.
Gordon,
it's
Gordon for late. Would you let us through, please?
Thank you.
Would you let us through, please? She'll sign all your autographs after the performance. Please, let us through. We're late, darling. Now, be sweet, sweetheart. Let us through, huh?
Please.
Will you please let us through, darling?
Miss Gordon,
I promise you. If you're patient, right after the performance, Miss Gordon will sign all your autographs. Wait, let us through now. Let us through. Let us through. Right after the show, she'll sign all your autographs, really. That's right. Now, believe me. Believe me. Right after the show, she'll sign everyone.
Please.
We're late.
You've got to talk to Jimmy for me about the props in the second act. That cigarette lighter has to work, and tell him to leave some matches on a bar in case.
I'll be at the Beverly Hills Hotel. The number is Crestview 6, 2251. If you need me, that's where I'll be. If you change your mind, you call.
Thank you, Mr. Victor.
Hello? Well, hello, Sophie. Oh, yes, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hold you up. I just forgot to get back. Listen, I'm kind of busy right now. Can I call you back? Okay.
Now.
Hello?
No, I killed that Jimmy.
No Esther isn't here either. Call back, will you?
Find a place. It took me 2 hours to get here. I'm sorry I was so crude to you today. You shocked me. I didn't ever expect to see you again. I've thought about you. I expected you to be a great big fat dame by now. This is just like it was on our wedding night, you know?
Why is she making
same way it was for me that night. I mean, I felt the same way that night. Are you all right up there?
This is ridiculous.
You haven't got a back door or somewhere you're gonna get out, are you? These big living rooms always turn me on.
Is everything all right, Miss Gort?
Sure.
I think you better get out there. Gus is on stage alone.
You all right up there?
Get the curtain down. I said, bring the curtain down. Which one is it?
It's up here. It's up there, Mr. Victor. Thank you.
How come you got your shirt off?
Hey! Wait! Get that damn curtain up right this minute! Get it up! Get that curtain up right now! You weren't gonna get it up!
Humiliating. Okay. I've changed, haven't I?
You have.
I've aged, haven't I?
No.
Oh, you can't say that I'm still the same baby I was when you first knew me. Not the same skin, not the same eyes. Do you know how old I am?
I don't want to know. You look terrific.
Oh, but I feel so different. Time is a killer, isn't it, folks? All those lonely nights. You know about lonely nights? I bet you do. How about those lonely days? How about them? How you doing? How about you? You know about those lonely nights?
I know what you mean.
You do?
I really enjoyed a wonderful experience.
Someone said you're the producer, are you?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh.
Oh, thank you. That's very nice.
Well, I like the leading parts, but there were too many old age parts.
Oh, old age?
Really? She's always good, don't
she? Oh, she's marvelous. Thank you.
Henry liked it. Henry. Here, tell him. He's the producer.
It's a very serious
piece. Oh, that means you didn't like it.
Well, what's wrong tonight? The place seems so mixed up.
Really?
Oh,
thank you. That's great.
Yeah.
Two of them hated it, and the other one didn't know what was going on at all.
Is it a disaster?
A disaster?
It's not a disaster. Now, listen, I want you to get Zeitz up here the first thing in the morning, but the first thing.
When you get out of my way, you stand there, go do what you're told.
I can open the door, beat it.
Okay, so I got a few laughs tonight. Listen, I've seen worse nights than that, babies. I've seen drunks in the audience, heart attacks, lines screwed up, nerves, dope, theaters burning. What are we talking about?
All right, Myrtle, all right. Listen to me. Half the audience loved the play. The other half hated it. But you're still my favorite star.
That's not what I was talking about, David. You know that.
Well, you're blind.
What are we going to do?
Look, it's Myrtle's problem. It's up to you, Myrtle, if you want to straighten yourself out. And she's the only one that can solve it.
Listen, you liars. You just shut up. You just shut up and don't talk to me anymore.
I'm on the stage,
Myrtle,
right?
What do you think is going wrong?
Nothing.
What do you think? She doesn't think anything's going wrong.
Is it the girl that was killed?
What girl?
No. The autograph hound. The
girl that was killed?
Have you seen her since she died?
Oh, Sarah, please.
Can I know?
Sarah, I don't know what the hell you're talking about. And the problem is here with us. Let's not complicate it with Never Neverland.
Look, the name of this play is The Second Woman. The girl dies. And Myrtle can't cope with it.
Who is this girl?
Did you see her?
All right. Okay, I have seen her, but not like you think. I mean, I made her up. She's mine. She's my fantasy. I wanted to see how it would feel like to be...
To be young again.
Whatever. If that makes you happy.
What the hell are you talking about?
Is she on the stage with you again tonight?
No.
What?
Look, would I let anybody go on stage for me? Are you crazy?
You know what's going on?
Can I take Myrtle to my spiritualist?
Oh, spiritualist? Wait a minute.
Come on.
Now, what is that?
Myrtle, you were never in it tonight, not for a moment. Now, I don't know whether it's because you don't want to, because you can't, because you're nuts. I don't know. Well, because the play's about aging and you're repulsed by it. I don't know, but I think it's an important play. And if you don't put yourself out, I mean, if you don't feel the pain of the losing of passion, and,
Look, if I put a call into New York, we'll be there in less than 2 hours. I'll take her to my spiritualist, and we'll be back in time for rehearsal tomorrow.
I don't want anybody to misunderstand this lunacy. It's made up. It's, I can control it. I just let my imagination go a little bit.
Are you sure it's just your imagination?
I can make her appear or disappear at will.
Hello, Sarah.
Oh, you must be Miss Gordon.
Yes, how are you?
Fine. Please sit down.
Thank you.
Sarah?
Is it okay if I join the seance?
Please do.
Thanks,
baby. Doris? Get the candles. Can't see in the pitch black, you know. And bring Frank in. We need a fan. When we close the doors, it gets stuffy in here, you know. Now, Sarah, from what you've told me on the phone, this could be a misplaced phenomenon. Looking for a way to cause trouble.
Well, I believe that Nancy exists, but... only in my mind. I'm an actress, and the play that we're doing right now is about the gradual lessening of my power as a woman as I mature. At some time in life, youth dies, and the second woman in us takes over. I believe that Nancy is the first woman in my own life.
Nancy, the girl who got killed?
Yes.
I see.
Actresses create characters. I created Nancy because I thought there were certain scenes in the play where I was having trouble visualizing my own life.
I'll do anything. I'll drink, I stay up all night.
You're so right.
I'll do just about anything.
To make my character more authentic, I always have.
I see. Oh, well, let's turn up our hands, everyone, and put them flat on the table. I'd like to see your palms, darling. Doris? Get a pan of water. Wash rag, please. Your hands were smudged. Must have brushed against you. This Nancy of yours, Myrtle, is a bad girl. She's very tough. I feel she's very near to us now.
Well, what do you want me to do?
Lower the lights, and Frank, light the candles, please.
I'm sorry.
You want to protect this kid, honey?
I just don't know how to explain it. It's like when you were a child and you had an imaginary friend. You know, someone that you made up? She doesn't exist.
Well, at least now you know.
At least I know what?
A lot of people think the young girl in us is important. Not too many years ago, I went around pretending I was 18. But I wasn't. I was 60. Take a snooze, huh? Some sleep, will you? Go on, sleep.
You too. Right. You know, it's not your fault. You're only 18. It's not my fault either. I'm an actress. I have to... Listen, you know who I am, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the door to Miss Good's suite is locked.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm locked out.
Oh, you're from up in the penthouse, aren't you?
I need to get in. Have you got the key?
I have some keys. I don't know if I have the key to Miss Good's room.
Would you try one, please? I'm sure you can get me in.
I haven't seen you in the movies in a while.
I'm doing a play.
Oh, I hear that. Let's see if this one works.
No, that doesn't.
Let's try this one.
What are you doing?
Don't worry, Sarah. I'm doing this to myself. I'm a little shook.
Use your bathroom. I'm a little shook up. Be all right with you if I spend the night.
Were you with her last night?
Yes. Manny, she's crazy.
Two precious hours of her life.
She's got to be replaced.
Oh, you want me to replace her now? One day before New York? Thank you very much. Let's go.
Yes.
Leo, tell everyone to take a break. We'll be back in a half hour.
Right.
Affair a couple of years ago. You know about it. 19-year-old girl. You don't think I was making a fool of myself? I think every time I took my shirt off, I didn't want to be younger. I had my nails done, my face massaged, had a container of breath spray in my pocket at all times. I left my wife, I left my children, and I had to suffer the humiliation of going back. After a scene with the kid where she very politely told me I was too old for her, I made her uncomfortable. But I understood that. All the work I'd ever done, she went to bed with, very passionately. And that's why I thought you'd like the play. It has so much of you in it.
You mean I shouldn't fool myself anymore to keep holding on?
No.
Then what? What do you mean, Manny?
What I'm trying to say is that you're a delicate, experienced, exciting woman who I find attractive beyond comprehension. A woman who amazes me with a lack of belief in herself.
Manny.
Jesus Christ.
I'm in trouble. I'm not acting. You know, the last day before New York, I'm always nervous. But I always win. I'm a strong person. I'm not some. But this age thing, it just has me coming off the wall.
Now, what's the line, Leo?
Vito, go in the jail.
Come on, boys. Pick up your cues. The scene has to bounce.
Vito, go in the jail.
What do you think I'm here for?
What need is that?
She needs loving. Every woman needs
take my wife home.
You... Good scene. It's about you.
Do whatever you want with
her.
You lock your kid in the bathroom. Is that it?
Let's take a break.
No, I want to see the fight by the number.
All right, by the number.
No, you've got to.
Sir,
go up.
Not one right.
No, but I'm not. Sir, no, I don't want to.
Quiet!
You're unwitting.
Oh, shut up, David!
All right. Murray,
David, where are the Bobbsey twins going? Will you find out where they're going? I don't want another disappearing act.
I'm out of control. Listen, I can't.
You mustn't be out of control.
You've got to get me somebody else. Look, somebody else. Not that first thing. That first thing did something. She did something she did. Crazy. I don't know what it's like.
Myrtle.
Again.
Myrtle.
We'll get a car. We'll.
Myrtle, don't you understand Manny's concern? With all this trouble, we want to be sure that everything is all right.
Everything is not all right. Don't you understand? I don't like the way that son of a bitch is treating me. He treats me like I'm some over-the-hill matron, and I don't like being spied on either. I can't go to the bathroom around here without somebody thinking I'm having a breakdown.
Are you all right?
Am I all right? Am I all right?
David, please let me talk to her alone.
Sarah, but...
Please.
All right, go.
Let's get out of here. Here, you call her. Don't tell me you don't know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about. You got me into this. You're going to get me out of here.
Well, you can do it.
You understand me?
You can do it,
Myrtle. What do you want me to do with your clothes?
You want me to go to the hotel and pack?
I don't care. It doesn't make any difference.
Would you, Kelly, please? After rehearsal, I'll take her into town.
Okay, sweetie.
We're going to call her. Somebody will get rid of her.
$6, Lily. How long are you going to be?
5 minutes.
All right. Hey, Mac.
There,
get going. Thank you. Come on, get going. Get going.
Are you sure you don't want me to stay with you?
No. You just introduced me to her. That's all I want.
And Miss Golden, you are looking completely charming today.
Thank you.
Can I get something for you? Ah.
Nice to see you again, Miss Gordon.
Thank you.
Hang on, that little bitch. Oh, there you are. Now. Don't be worried, promise? Don't be nervous. I'll call you, okay? Goodbye, Sarah. I'll call you.
Maurice. Can I take your order now, Miss Gordon?
Nothing for me.
Miss Drake.
Could we do this thing now?
Oh, I think we'd better go to my room.
A little apricot brandy.
Nothing at all. Thank you.
Very well.
Sit in that comfortable chair. I like this all when it creaks. Now, Nancy is her name?
There you are. Oh, beautiful.
What is that?
It means I'm no fucking spirit.
What does that mean?
I've never bothered you. You want to kill me. I devoted my life to you, to movies, to music, to theater. I'm 17 years old. I like sex. I like to turn people on. And that's what the theater is. It's sex. It's like getting laid.
What did you do to her?
Frightened, and you're a coward.
I have this play, you know that. I have to do it. If you hurt me, I won't be able to act.
Really? I'm sorry.
Don't do this.
Stand still.
No. I just want to shake your hand.
Don't do this.
Don't you want to touch me?
No.
Gordon, why don't you sit in the lobby here and have a drink or something? Well, I'll get you some nice glass of wine.
No, thank you.
You sure?
Goodbye.
Do you want me to call someone?
No, thank you. Thank you both.
Yes, miss?
Hello, Wally. You don't remember me.
It's Gordon, by God. It's so good to see you back. I didn't know who you were when you first walked in here looking like a frump. Well, welcome back.
Is he upstairs, Wally?
Yeah, it's been about, half an hour or so.
Is he by himself? You know, I really missed you.
I missed you, too.
Hello, how are you?
Fine, how are you?
Fine, how are you?
Fine.
It's really you.
Really is.
The big star pays the little actor a visit. You know what I was thinking about? I was thinking about my life. I was thinking about the opening. I want to get some sleep.
Do you love me?
I'm going to close this door.
What am I asking? What am I asking? Come on, take a chance. Listen, look, let's take this play. Let's dump it upside down and see if we can't find something human in it. I mean, there has to be more when two people have cared for each other for a long time. Besides, agony. Are you with me? I'm not bitter at you.
It's not right. No.
You are.
It's because I know you. I know you very well. I know what you want me to do. You want me to make an ass of myself on that stage.
Well, they don't pay me enough to make an ass of myself. Do you understand?
Well, look at this. You don't invite me in, you don't offer me a cup of coffee, a cigarette. Well. Well. Love moves at a hell of a rate of speed, doesn't it?
Well, where? Leo?
$200,000 advance. I gotta give that money back. You know, I...
The situation remains the same. The ads have been bought. The money... Now, wait a minute. The money's been spent. They're in.
I don't care if the theater's burning down. Not now.
It's Miss Gordon. She's on the phone.
From Miss Gordon.
What phone? What phone?
The other phone. Backstage, upstairs, it's the phone. You got the call from Philadelphia. You did
something wrong up there. Right?
Manny, I'm going out of my mind.
I'll see you in a minute.
Frank, there's a law here. Right?
Hello, Myrtle? Myrtle? Jimmy, come here.
Is she all right?
Is she coming?
Did you talk to her? What did she say? Was she sober?
I don't know. I don't think so.
You tell her we had search parties out for her, the police, everybody?
Yeah, but is she all right? She said she was fine.
Oh, what else did she say?
Nothing. She said she'd be here in time to get dressed on opening night.
Hey, what's happening?
Well...
Anything else?
No.
What happened?
Does it make? Either she'll be here or she won't. She'll be ready or she won't. I can't say I'm not depressed, but it's not the end of my life.
What are we gonna do? Say she was hit by a car? Got pneumonia? What do you want to do, sir?
We'll just have to wait.
Thank you.
hell is the point of drinking that? We're calm.
Depressed. There's a difference between being calm and being depressed. You know, with all the pressure the whole time we were in New Haven, even when she went wrong, she made me laugh. In some crazy way, with all of her craziness and all of her nuttiness, it was more real for me being up than being in it. In some nutty way, it seemed like something real. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Where the hell is she?
I feel rotten, though, do you?
Yeah. I don't think I'm going to celebrate anything.
What are those? You know, we've got reputations and...
Yeah. Well,
I don't...
You know about reputations. As a good friend of mine once said, reputations are money.
I know, but I don't know what'll cut out this lousy feeling of embarrassment and shame that we...
Well...
You know, there are people out there waiting to see me. And you've backed many a fine play, and I've written a lot of good ones, you know.
Manny! Kelly, she's here.
Oh, thank God.
What's up? That's all right. Sarah! Sarah! Right. Manny, thank God she's here.
What?
She's here.
All right, get everybody out of the hallway. Now.
Everybody?
Now.
Out.
Okay.
Hallway, please.
What's up, please?
Everything's fine. She's here. Get ready. Get your clothes on. Get ready.
I'm late.
Well, we'll get some coffee in you, then we'll see.
Buddy.
Don't help him, Leo.
don't help her, goddammit.
Honey,
leave her alone!
All horse shit. Yeah.
Goddammit. Now, you stay
away. Stay
away! Stay away!
What does it prove?
Want me to leave?
No, no. You're part of the family. What the hell's the difference? I can't believe she'd walk in this drunk.
Manny.
I'm closing this show. We're closing.
She's here. She's here. Wait. Where's Jimmy? Jimmy? Get the cast on. She's here. Come on, quickly. Go around back.
She's here! All right, everybody. We'll be going up in a few minutes. 5 or 10, I'm not sure. Now get your clothes on. Come down stage. We'll be going. All right. Everything is fine. We'll be going up. Thank you. Thank you.
Make up.
Yes.
Sweetheart, no. Drink this.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm a foolish girl.
Okay, well, I'll bet you 65 you don't make it out of this dressing room. You make it to your second entrance, you know who's going to be waiting for you? Maurice.
Barris.
Now, David, I know this is crazy, merely conjecture. But she's drunk enough.
I'm alone.
I bet the audience is going to love her.
No, I'm not alone. I'm not alone. I've been...
Leo, I think you should tell Mr. Victor and Mr. Samuels. It's good. I don't know what to do about the audience.
5 minutes, Jimmy.
We'll be there. Rowdy.
We'll be there, Jimmy.
Cat calls.
Al.
I don't think we can hold them.
Leave.
Okay,
after that, I was just floating.
I think we'll have to make some kind of announcement.
I would always think of Tony.
Leo.
Here,
5 minutes, Manny.
Yeah, she can do it.
Yeah.
I think it's hard. I never had children.
and gentlemen. Our producer, Mr. David Samuels, would like to say a few words to you. Mr. Samuels.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. May I really apologize for this long wait, and thank you for your patience. We've had a small disturbance and problem backstage, and the curtain will go up in a minute. Thank you.
Okay, props in place. Everybody ready? Curtain going up. Places. House lights down. Places, please. Curtain.
You gotta understand, it's a shock to me to see you. I'm not seeing you alone on a street corner somewhere. I didn't bump into you in the crowd.
What the hell is going on here? Who is this Dave?
This is Virginia. This is my ex-wife, 15 years ago. And this is my new wife. Say hello to Carlin.
Hello.
Carla, Charlie Spice, my brother-in-law, Charlie Spice.
Get a glass of water. I can. Never mind the water. I said, what do you want?
Dad's gonna hit you again.
What kind of woman are you?
Hey, come here, sit down.
Sit down. Oh, my arm's
sit down.
Stop it, Dad.
Sit down.
Hey, Tony, take it easy. You're bigger than she is.
Hey, Tony, leave her alone! God damn it! Look, I even wore this veil because...
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm a very foolish woman, and this is very embarrassing. It's just that I'm alone. No, I'm not alone. I've been living with this guy for several years, and... Now, he's married to someone else before Tony. I don't even know where he is.
I was just floating around.
Can I?
Go on.
You were married to him, right, honey?
Yeah, but it didn't mean anything. It was just for a little bit of time. It didn't mean anything.
Do you have any kids?
No. I don't have any kids, and I'm...
Ginger. Tony. Hey, Tony. Put her down, Tony.
Leave me alone, will you, Lena? This woman is hurt. I'm not going to do anything.
Put her down,
I'm going to lay her down in the bed.
Come on, we all love you, Tony. Come on, you want to hit me? Go ahead and hit me. Tony. Come on, we all love you, Tony. Come on, you want to hit me? Go ahead and hit me. You're my friend, you're my best friend. Everybody loves you. Your kids love you.
Honey, you better get her dressed. You better hurry. We don't have much time.
Bury that bastard.
I think it's going very well. Keys, please.
House lights down.
See you on stage.
Okay.
Places, please. Curtain.
No, your sister isn't here.
No. Oh, she told you. There you are. No, there's no point. I said there's no point.
Miss Gordon.
No, she went to see her first cousin.
Sure. I've seen a lot of drunks in my day, but I never seen anybody as drunk as you and still be able to walk. You're fantastic.
Thank you, Bobby.
No, she went to see her first cousin. That's goddamn sick and tired of walking into this house and finding it empty. Mm-hmm. Look, I can't talk now, all right? I'm gonna hang on. Okay. Well, listen, it'll either work out or it won't.
This is funny, you know? It's very funny. Hysterical. You want to recap it? All right. I run off to the Beverly Hills Hotel, and I find myself a little innocent girl, and I sit there with her. And all she can think about is my graying temples. And you run off with, do you love me?
You object to my going out, right?
Yes, I do.
And my drinking?
Yes.
Somehow a cocktail here and there is very destructive.
Yes, I think it is, very.
Well, I've heard your every point of view. Every story you tell turns out the same way. A constant, long-winded recital about what's wrong with everyone in the whole world.
I tell you what I think is important for you.
Well, I am not me. I used to be me. I'm not me anymore.
What the hell do you want from me? You want me to get down on my knees? What the hell do you want?
Everything you can't give me. I want youth. Super strength. Dream building. Happiness. Fun. Emotion.
Babe.
Practically anything.
Hey,
no, no.
I love you.
No.
I love you.
Hey, no.
I am Superman!
Hey.
I am Superman!
Oh, you're weird. You make me feel...
I am so strong you can't believe it.
Hey,
I am... I am Superman! We are not we.
What are we fighting about?
We are...
What are we fighting about, Marty?
We are absolutely different people than we were. When I look at my face in the mirror when I'm shaving in the morning, you know what I see? I can see it then in my face. It's hard to cover it up. There's
what?
Something deeply cynical about my face. It's hard to cover it up.
Congratulations.
It's hard to cover it up. It is very hard to cover it up. My heart. My heart pounds, you understand? My heart pounds, it pounds. My stomach is empty. And I feel like screaming. I am restless with this pose.
Well, I am not me.
And I know that I am someone else.
Do you think I am too?
Yes!
Hey, it's definite then. We've been invaded. There's someone posing here as us, and you're right. There is something definitely wrong with your smile. There's one question I'd like answered.
Yes? What is it?
What do you suppose they've done with us? Do you think they killed us? You think they murdered us? You think we're dead? Or do you think we're just losing our sense of humor? Do you know I used to be very funny?
Whoa!
When were you ever funny?
When was I ever funny?
I never heard you tell one stinking joke and you never laugh at anyone else.
I used to be funny! I used to be very funny.
When?
When I was a kid.
Marty, I've got it.
Good.
I've got the answer.
Good.
Marty, this is terrific. Terrific. This is a wonderful idea. It's just so easy that it's silly. Isn't it marvelous the way the mind works?
Yes.
I mean, it's sick the way the mind works. You don't see it, do you? Listen, it's easy. It's so easy. The telephone rings. You answer, right? You get sick, you go to the doctor. Your heart gets broken. You get someone else. We're grim, right? We're grim and we're depressed and we're yeah. All right, we don't have to sit here and take this. We can turn on the lights. We can dance a little. We can... If we need touching, we can touch each other. Hey, Marty, we have each other.
Virginia, for God's sakes, I don't want to take...
Hey, no, honest, this is simple. It's simple. Honest to God, this is the best idea. It's just so simple, you don't see it. It means I love you, that's what it means. I love you. And I don't care if you don't think I'm beautiful anymore.
I do.
And you don't think I'm funny.
You're hysterical.
Well, you don't think I'm capable.
I don't think you're capable, no. Because I swear to God, I never thought about if you were capable or not.
Yeah, but now you will see. Now you'll think about it, and because you think about it, I'll pay you. Because that's what I want to be. I want to be capable.
Okay, you're capable. You're capable, and you're pretty, and you're young, and you're wonderful, and you're great, and you're outstanding, and you're...
And I love you.
And you love me. And if I get angry with you, I punch you right in the nose. Is that right?
No. If you get angry, you get over it.
It's a lousy idea.
If you're depressed, you get over it. Right. If you're selfish, which you are 90% of the time, right? Well, you give me a chance.
All right, angry, happy, depressed, happy, the other way, happy, changing, happy, killing, happy, depressed, angry, happy. Everything is happy,
this
right?
Is,
that's the answer.
This is so brilliant.
Worst idea I've ever heard in my entire life.
It's just so simple, you reject it.
I'm getting older. What do we do about that?
I do want to be your friend.
Yeah, well, I don't want to be your friend.
Oh, come on, let's be friends, Marty.
No.
to be friends. Put it.
Okay. Stand up, please. Want to see something wonderful?
Yes!
How about if you stand over here?
All right.
Okay, then I'm standing over here, right? Now, could you do me a favor?
Certainly.
Could you raise your right leg? The other way, please? No. The other way, please. No, seriously. We will walk to each other. We will try to clasp hands.
Yes.
And we will grab each other's leg as we pass.
Oh, that's wonderful.
This is an athlete's trick.
Okay.
Instead of going, hey, baby, dad.
Now?
Whatever you say. Ready? Hey, baby, what do you say, baby? Don't look out! No! Yes! Oh! Okay!
Thank you. I just adored it.
Did you?
Hey, Bowers, Nash, backstage, you won't come out.
Come over here.
Hey,
where is it?
Bob.
I am so drunk I can hardly stand on these 2 feet. So
I wouldn't have known.
I will call you when I'm a little clearer.
Peter?
Yes.
Peter? You know Dorothy? My wife Dorothy? Peter Bogdanovich?
Lady. Oh, lady. It's a privilege.
We should do a picture together.
Oh, it's good.
You liked it. Hey,
I have so much admiration for you.
It
was wonderful. Wonderful.
Bobby.
Bobby.